Bee and insect populations have been in decline across Britain as a consequence of habitat loss, climate change, and pesticides. But the coronavirus lockdown may have thrown these important pollinators a lifeline.
As you can see, there's a stunning array of grasses and wildflowers right next to the roadside, providing an important source of food for bees, insects, and other pollinators. And campaigners are calling on councils to make this the new normal by cutting grass verges less and allowing nature to flourish. I've been finding out what councils and we ourselves can do at home to allow insects and bee populations to recover across the United Kingdom.
Well, when we started the Blue Campaign, we suggested that for gardens, it was sensible to maybe consider 10% of your garden. So however big your garden is, just think about setting aside 10%, maybe a bit at the end of the garden, and just leave that be, let the grasses grow. Within those grasses, you'll find a huge number of species. And you know, the Blue Campaign encourages these corridors of long grass from, say, you know, one hole in the fence to another hole in the fence across your garden. And then it means that it's not just letting hedgehogs through, you know, it's letting short-tailed field voles, shrews, frogs, toads, slow worms, grass snakes. These are all creatures that need to disperse. So, you know, the Blue Campaign is trying to say we can do a little bit less, which is actually a fantastic benefit for nature.
Bees are the world's most important pollinators and critical for our food. I spoke with wine expert and Bumblebee Trust ambassador, Ollie Smith, to find out how we can support bees.
I got into beekeeping slightly by accident. I wanted to make a contribution to biodiversity, to the environment. I loved the idea of having my own honey because there was a correlation for me between the somewhereness of honey, tasting of its place, as you get with wine. You know, a wine, depending on where it's grown, takes on certain characteristics. And then for many, many years, I successfully kind of had my two hives, which produced an extraordinary amount of honey. And it convinced me that these little insects that are so charismatic do so much for our environment. To allow nature to flourish and bees and insects, I would say leave a patch weld in your garden is a great shout, even if it's a tiny patch. But in addition to that, I would say if you can get a small amount of wildflower seed, the Bumblebee Conservation Trust have them available. You'll get some free if you join. All of that stuff is super helpful and it looks great. It makes you feel good. You know, here we are in lockdown. It's a small gesture, but it will have a massive impact. The dog is licking my crotch. I'm so sorry. I think my top tip of all is get yourself some borage. Bees love the stuff. It looks pretty, and already this year, the flowers have erupted and it's just offered so much forage to so many different insects. I mean, I can see bumblebees, lots of bees in front of me here, but it's a small area doing a very big job. I think the lockdown, without question, has had a benefit for nature. It's been a tragic time for so many people, but one of the brighter stories has without question been just how much biodiversity is around us. I mean, you can see, you know, I'm surrounded by bees and bumblebees in my sagebrush here. But with the verges, for example, being left to ramble a bit, you know, it is a haven for wildlife. And I'm absolutely in favour of mowing less, allowing far more rewilding to happen. And apart from anything else, to turn our backs on the polluting ways that we've rather unthinkingly just taken on as habits, that journey we don't really need to take. Or it might be just that bit of behaviour with a bit of single-use plastic. All of those things that in lockdown have decreased because of the way we've had to live may be to nature's advantage. And I just hope if that's the case, that long-term we're able to allow it to grow.
A third of British bees and hoverflies are in decline. The loss of insects has far-reaching consequences for entire ecosystems. Insects provide a food source for many birds, amphibians, bats, and reptiles, while plants rely on insects for pollination. Jill Perkins is the CEO of the Bumblebee Conservation Trust.
In this country, in the UK, we have over 250 bees. honeybees we call domesticated because we look after them. The other, the solitary bees and bumblebees we call wild, are wild bees. And it is only the wild bees that are at risk of extinction and decline. So I would encourage everybody to look and research bee-friendly flowers. Not all flowers are bee-friendly. So on the Bumblebee Conservation website, we have a tool called Bee Kind. And there's over 700 bee-friendly plants. It's all free. You can go in and you can work out what plant by colour, by petal, by time of the year that it flowers. There's a huge choice in there. And we would encourage everybody to try and plant a bee-friendly flower or some bee-friendly flowers in their garden.
Dr. Trevor Dine from Plant Life has given us his tips for the best way to maintain your lawns and verges to allow pollinators, insects and bees to thrive.
We're often asked at Plant Life what's the best way to look after our lawns and manage them for wildlife. And so in order to answer that question, we came up with Every Flower Counts, which is Britain's largest citizen science survey of our lawns. All we do is ask people to put down a metre square on their lawn, count the number of flowers within that, and then we give them a personal nectar score, telling them how much nectar their lawn is producing and how many bees it can support. And what we found was quite a surprise. The highest amounts of nectar and flowers were produced on lawns that were actually mown once every month. What we found is that you get these long unmown areas of grass that home to plants like oxeye daisy, meadow buttercup and knapweed, and they produce a much wider range of plants over the summer period. So what we recommend now is that you do a sort of Mohican style haircut in your garden and have some of these short areas that are mown once a month, and alongside them the longer grasses with the different range of flowers. And this is the best way to maximise nectar production in your garden. If you want to take part in Every Flower Counts, come to the Plant Life website, have a look for Every Flower Counts, and there you'll see how you can do the survey in May and again in July. And it's a great way to get involved and have a look at the flowers in your lawn. Like I say, we'll give you a personal nectar score showing you exactly how many bees your lawn can support.
I've just got home from filming bees, and on the floor I found this little chap who's absolutely exhausted. I've given him some sugar solution and I'm just hoping he's going to survive, because as we found out, bees in Britain need every bit of support that they can get.